available to those using internet-connected versions of Excel, so like Office 365, Excel on the web or mobile, you have two functions that can help you translate text in Excel. These are the Translate and the Detect Language functions. Now, because these functions are only available on web-based versions of Excel, you do have to be connected to the internet for them to work. Another important thing to know about these functions is that they do not translate other functions, just only text. So, if you do need to translate any functions, make sure to watch my tutorial on how to use the Functions Translator add-in, and that can help you out on that front. And lastly, these functions only work with text. So if your cells are not formatted as text, they might not work for you. You can use the translate function whenever you want to translate text that's in your Excel sheet. So for example, let's say that we want to translate this text on the left into Spanish. I would type equals translate, open parentheses, and this function has three arguments. In the first, we need to select the text that we want to translate. So in this example, this is going to be the text in cell A2. A comma, and then the next argument wants us to let it know what the source language is. And the source language refers to the language that the text that you want to translate, or the source, is in. And you can do this one of three ways. You can scroll down the list until you find the language that you want. Or if you already know the language code that you want to use, so like here for English, this would be EN, you can just type this yourself, just making sure that the EN is in quotation marks. Or you can leave this field blank. When you leave it blank, Excel will use the auto detect feature to figure out which language it is. And you do that just by typing another comma, and then that forces it to skip to the next argument in the function. Before we go on, just a quick note about using AutoDetect. Just like any other online translator, this may from time to time detect the wrong language, so it's always a good idea to double check your formula results. The next and final argument is the target language, and the target language is the language that you want the text translated into. So like before, for this argument, we can either type the language code in quotation marks, which is what I'm going to do here because I know that the language code for Spanish is ES, or you can scroll down this list and click on the language that you want. Then when you're done, close the parentheses and you can either tap out of it or press enter to get your translation. And let's just drag this formula down so we can do the other translations. So while the translation was trying to populate, you may have noticed that little green circle on the left of the cell and then also the message that said busy. So one thing to know about these formulas is that they use up a lot of resources to run. So you shouldn't notice a problem if you're only translating a few items. But if you're translating a big range, you might have to wait longer for your results, or you could even end up getting an error. The next language function is the detect language function, and it does exactly what its name implies. It detects the language of the text in a cell. So we would type detect language, open parentheses, and this formula has just a single argument. We need to just select the cell that has the text that we want to get the language code for. So we select that, press enter, and then we'll just drag it down to populate the language codes for the other examples. So because the results of the detect language function is the language code, you can combine it with the translate function whenever you need to translate something. So we have this text that we need to translate into English. So we'll type equals translate, open parentheses, and we'll select the text that we want translated. And for the source language, because these are all various languages, I'm going to use the language code generated by the detect language. So you can either select the cell with the language code, or you can actually just nest the detect language function right into the translate function. So with that nested, we select the cell with the text again, close the parentheses, comma, and then now we can either type the code for English, which is EN, or because this is also my system language, I can just skip it, close the parentheses, and press enter. And now I'm going to copy this down. So these formulas are amazing, but not perfect. So this first item, hola, tradúceme, into hello, translate me, this should be in Spanish. We can see here that this did not return the Spanish language code of ES. Instead, for whatever reason, it thinks that this is Slovak. In this example, I would be better off typing the language code for Spanish to get a better translation than to use the detect language shortcut. So I will change this to ES. And now that changes my translation. Now, I do speak Spanish, so it's easier for me to identify those errors. However, I don't speak any of these other languages of Italian or Hindi. And while the results of the detect language confirm that the correct source language was identified, if your project requires accuracy, it may be a good idea to either cross-check your results with another online translator or colleague. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.